Welcome back to the History of English Literature. Today we are going to look at the origin of English drama. In today's video, we will be taking a look at the predecessors of drama. What are the predecessors of drama? Before the development of the proper drama, we had many different kinds of dramas, that is plays. These are mystery plays, miracle plays, morality plays and interludes. But each had a short life that we are going to look at in this video in detail. In fact, it is very important to note at the beginning that the Greek and Roman traditions had a very thriving dramatic tradition in place. But however, when it comes to the Middle English period in England, we do not see much of an influence of any of those Greek or Roman plays taking a part over there. And in fact, the English dramatic tradition, which begins to emerge from the Middle English period through the Elizabethan period, it had got hardly anything to do with the ancient classic drama. In that sense, we can even say that English dramatic tradition owes very little to that of the ancient classical tradition. So some of the predecessors of drama before Shakespeare, we could be named as follows, like mystery plays, miracle plays, morality plays and the interludes. In fact, each of these kinds of drama, they had a very short life and they did not thrive beyond a certain particular historical period, and their content was largely religious, moral, as the title implies as well. However, it is very important to take a look at these traditions in order to able to properly understand the upcoming Shakespearean dramas and the Elizabethan drama came to be featured in that certain historical phase. So moving on, we will first take a look at the mystery plays, which had begun to emerge from the 11th and 12th century, which is right after the Norman conquest. So it is very interesting that the drama had a past which is as early as the Norman tradition itself. The rebirth of drama after classical traditions of Greek and Roman plays. It had its rebirth and in fact within church premises. It was the church and its liturgy who began to develop the first forms of drama. This was in fact primarily conceived as a way to teach Bible to the illiterate commoners, because Bible was then written and popularized mainly in Latin and other languages which were not accessible to the commoners. So clergy thought that of an innovative way to teach the Bible to the commoners, and they thought of enacting plays, enacting stories from the Bible which would be of interesting to the commoners. This was also a way to teach them about ways of world and also introduce them to the various historical and biblical aspects as well. So these were primarily liturgical drama. So as the name implies, the content was primarily from the Bible, and actors were also predominantly from the clergy and who were part of the church. And due to its didactic purpose and due to schematic structure, it was entirely under the church control. So it is very interesting to note that in the beginning, church had a very important role to play in the development of drama. Just as the church continued to control many of the social and political technical affairs of those times. The name mystery needs to be a little bit attention. The mystery in fact means religious truth. It used to mean religious truth during those times, and also mean secret, sacred, when it was translated from the French language. Latin and French being the dominant language of those times, mystery plays seems quite appropriate a name for them, and they were also mostly based on scenes and stories from the Bible. And one interesting aspect in terms of language is that since they were adaptations from the Bible for commoners, the Latin began to heavily replaced by the vernacular English, the English which was prevalent during that time. And the venue also, it's quite an interesting shift that happened across a period. The venue was initially outside, right outside of the cathedral, because these plays were staged for the commoners who came to attend the church. And gradually, as the number increase and the popularity increases, we find that the venue shift from church to the towns square where more people can attend, and also more kinds of elaborate arrangements could be made, and gradually it even shifted to a form of pageants. Pageants are very important in the history of drama because they were like a traveling company, traveling drama company. They used to have these boxes with a huge vehicles which had actors and plays, which also had elaborate arrangements. They used to travel across the town, and the people all used to gather different points, different corners, in order to watch the drama which is being staged. So the when you gradually shift from the church towards the town square or town's center, and the control also gradually shifted from church to the guilds. The guilds are the trade people, or the a group of traders who form the companies of the acting drama. They raise the financier, they take decisions together, they also end up ruling the town's square in the name of a council. So the control gradually shifts from the church towards these trademen guilds. So now we also note that just as these changes takes place, actors also begin to change. The clergy no longer then permitted to be a part of the acting teams, but then others. The commoners, the merchants, the peasants were the part of the guilds. They all replaced clergy as actors also. At this context, it is important to remember that this edict of 20, that is 1210, which forbids clergy from participating in any of these dramatic forms, and this is also a moment when we witness a growing secularization of the drama. So, the medieval mystery plays focused on the representation of the Bible stories in churches as the performance, which had to be reached to the common people. They told of subjects such as the creation, Adam and Eve, the murder of Abel, and the last judgments are the best example for this kind of mystery plays. Often they were performed together in cycles which could last for days. Now, what are these cycle plays? This is a phrase used by scholars of medieval theatre to refer to the sequences of the episodes that dramatized the sweep of Christian salvation history from the creation to the judgment. Now let us sum up what we have seen in this session. So the rebirth of drama happened in church, because of its liturgy form of drama acting. It is developed as a part of ceremonial religious feasts, such as in the East, especially on the Easter days. You know, what is liturgical drama? It is a way to teach Bible to the illiterate commoners. It has the didactic purpose, and it was fully under the control of the church. What is the meaning of mystery? Mystery is nothing but is a religious truth or a secret. The mystery plays are based on the scenes and the stories from the Bible. So gradually the church language, that is Latin, was replaced by the vernacular English, as well as there was a shift of the venue from the outside of the cathedral to the town square, as well as the pageants were developed at this time. The pageants were the traveling agency. So as well as the control is shifted from church to the guilds, that is the trading guilds. While under the control of the church, the actors were predominantly from the church. But later, ongoing time, the actors, others also involved in this acting career, apart from the church. So the mystery plays focused on representation of the Bible stories in churches, such as the creation of the world, Adam and Eve, the murder of the Abel, and the last judgment. Now let us look at some of the questions regarding the mystery plays. The remaining three, that is morality plays, interludes, and as well as the development of romances, we look into the next video. So what is now let's look at some of the MCQs. The first question is, the mystery plays deal with option A, the life deed of saints, B, biblical themes, C, heaven and hell, D, moral values. The answer for this question is, the mystery plays deal with biblical themes. Now we move on to the next question. What was the purpose of mystery plays acted in the church? What was the purpose of the church to enact the plays, especially the mystery plays? Option A, to entertain the people. B, to control the people. C, to dictate the Bible. D, to teach Latin language. Actually, the church enacted the plays on the ceremonial occasions to dictate the Bible stories as well as the teachings of the Bibles to the common people. They thought that through acting, through the performance, through creating drama, through making this a play, the common people can acquire the knowledge of the Bible very easily, because at that time all the Bibles and the teaching principles were only in the language of Latin. So to reach the common people, the church used the technique of acting or drama to reach the common people. The next question is, what is liturgical drama? Option A, relating stories from Bible and of the saints. It's about romantic stories, or it's about the dramas in Latin language only, or it's about a historical drama. Actually, the liturgical drama relating to the stories from the Bible and the saints. It is a type of play acted within or near the church and relating stories from the Bible and of the saints. We move on to the next question. The subjects such as the creation, Adam and Eve, the murder of Abel, and the last judgments are the dash plays. Morality, mystery, interludes, or romances. Actually, these subjects, creation, Adam and Eve, these are all comes from Bible. They all come from Bible. So these can be categorized under the stories of plays of mystery plays. The next question is, who are the pageants? Actually, pageants, public entertainment, consist of a procession of people in elaborate colorful costumes or an outdoor performance of the historical scenes. They also used a vehicle to travel one place to another place. What is the meaning of the word mystery? The meaning of the word mystery is, mystery means secret and religious truth. Thank you. Have a great day.